Well, good evening, everybody. My name is Ben, and I am a conspiracy theorist. Have I come to the right meeting?
Yeah.
Oh, good. Yes, I am a conspiracy theorist. I admit that quite openly. I have a tinfoil hat with me. It's in my bag, waiting in case I need it. The moment I don't, hopefully I won't. Now, I think I'll be all right, actually, for now. I'll put it on if it is necessary. Yes, I am a conspiracy theorist. However, this does not mean that I think everything that happens is a conspiracy. And that's a caricature that is often levelled against people like me. Now, the Earth is not flat. I promise you. It's true. The Moon is not a spaceship. Lewis Hamilton is not Barack Obama's son. Even I have my limits. But that was me, the portering Buddha. Yes, I was a hospital porter for 23 years. And that, as I showed you before, I'll go back to that. That's my website, which is called Hospital Porters Against the New World Order. I thought, there used to be a guy in America called Jack McLam who had a group called Police Against the New World Order. And I thought, what's good for police is good for hospital porters. So that's me there. I was a hospital porter for 23 years, and I lost my job. I got sacked, and it was in very mysterious circumstances. And guess what? I think it was a conspiracy. And not only that, there are some similarities between what happened to me and what happened to the subject of what I'm going to talk about this evening. Could anyone get me a glass of water? Is that all right? So I should grab one before I start. Thanks, Richard. Yeah. As I said, what happened to me was a conspiracy. What I'm going to talk about tonight is a conspiracy. But I do believe that there's evidence for what I'm going to say. I will be presenting what I think is evidence for what I'm going to say. And there are some remarkable similarities between what happened to me. Thanks very much, mate. Cheers.
It's actually Neat Jim.
That's even better, even better. Richard, can I have some tonic, please? Yeah, there are some, as I said, some similarities between the two cases. Now, what happened, what I'm going to talk about today, it all kicked off. It's an open case, it's still going on today, but it happened a long time ago. In fact, it happened 74 years ago, but it is still relevant to the world we live in today, I believe. This is the central figure of the subject I'm going to talk about this evening. This is Helen Duncan. Now, she was born in 1897 in Callander in Perthshire, Scotland. And she is a psychic medium. She was a psychic medium, clairvoyant, psychic. There's different words I know. And I know there's different types of mediumship as well. So if I get some of the terminology wrong, I will endeavour not to. But I'm well aware that there's different words for different things within this area, but she is what's commonly known as a psychic medium. Now, there's different types of mediums. You get the type, you go to a spiritualist church, and you have the medium who stands at the front and goes, is there anyone here called John? John, Dave, Steve, come on, help me here. That's clairvoyant mediumship, there's nothing wrong with that. That's the most common form. But there's other forms. There's trance mediumship, which you'll sometimes see done on television where someone is possessed. You'll get someone who is appears to be possessed by a spirit of some kind. There's physical mediumship, which actually creates changes in the world, including the noises like raps, which is that kind of noise. And Helen Duncan was an elite club of mediums because she was a manifestation medium. Now, a manifestation medium is where you is basically where they create images in the air. They actually create images from something called ectoplasm. And these images can turn into figures of your loved ones who've died and other things like that, recognizable objects in very, very, sometimes like luminous 3D images. It's almost like 3D printing from the spirit world. It's amazing. But of course, this will depend on your opinion because this, of course, is not universally accepted, and some people will say that Helen Duncan and all mediums and all people like her, what they're really doing is trickery, it's conjuring, it's illusion. But whatever your opinion on this matter, I think you'll still find what I'm going to talk about interesting. Helen Duncan was a person who became quite famous. She was world famous. I don't know if she actually travelled abroad in any way, but I know that she travelled the country, and she appeared in spiritualist churches, in seance rooms, in private sittings, at privately organised events. She would go and she would turn up, and she did earn a living from that way. It was her job. Now, if you Google Helen Duncan's name, before long you'll come across these images. And this is very often, this is probably the most common image you'll find of her. Now, these were photographs taken by Harvey Metcalf in 1928. And they were actually published in several magazines, including, first of all, in a magazine in Australia. There's a chap in Australia I know who's been researching this. Now, what you see here is Helen Duncan apparently in a psychic trance. She's actually in a trance and she is releasing ectoplasm from her body, which is forming into these two spirits. You see these two spirit figures here. Except that's not what's happening, is it? It's pretty obvious that this is not the case. This is not a photograph that is real. These apparent spirits are obviously dummies. I mean, the faces are models. I mean, they look to me like papier-mâché, perhaps, that's been painted. And the